Wonderful morning. It's been an exciting week, beloved. Can't you see? We're learning how to go from being children to being mature in the Lord, where we are concerned about what concerns the Lord, and where we learned how to follow Him in this generation. Beloved, there are so many miracles that await us as we touch people for Him, as we effect change by the anointing of the Holy Spirit. I remember many years ago riding a bus on a major city overseas, and a man came and sat next to me, and the Holy Spirit gently ministered to me, just tell him Jesus loves you. I struggled with it because that is not something that people hadn't heard before. Sometimes you may say such a thing to someone and they will be offended and say, so what, or whatever, you know, such ridiculous or arrogant responses. But after struggling with it, I decided to obey the Spirit. And I just looked at that man, I said, you know, Jesus loves you. And before I knew it, beloved, tears started streaming down his face. Wow, I was amazed. My Father worketh hitherto, and I work. Because he said it, I merely repeated what he said. That's what we are learning this week, co-laborers with God. And at the next bus stop, that man was getting off the bus. And I asked him, where are you going? He said, I'm going to the bookstore there to buy me a Bible. That man got saved because an agent of the kingdom was riding on the bus and had a word in season for him. Beloved, don't wait until you get a pulpit to preach. No. Don't wait until your name is in the light. You can be a powerful influence, a weapon against the kingdom of darkness in the lives of people every day if you listen to God. That's all that matters. Don't walk past people that need you and you're waiting to preach somewhere. Be faithful to God every day. Listen to Jesus. When the people were contending with him because he had healed a man on the Sabbath day, John chapter 5 verse 17. But Jesus answered them, my Father worketh hitherto, and I work. In other words, if my Father has not worked, there is no point working because nothing will come of it. You will not produce fruit that will last forever. Therefore, the Jews sought the more to kill him because he not only had broken the Sabbath, but said also that God was his Father, making himself equal with God. Oh, what ignorance. God is all our Father. And he wants to work with us. But their Old Testament concept, they didn't have the concept of a personal relationship with God. They only knew the God of judgment. But beloved, even in that Old Testament, that cherubim of glory overshadowing a seat that was called the mercy seat, even though you have to enter with blood and if you miss a step, you're dead, but it was still a mercy seat, even in that day. Glory to God. They didn't understand that the Son of God was among them. And they said they want to kill him because he said that God was his Father and he was making himself equal with God. Oh, beloved. Then answered Jesus and said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, the Son can do nothing of himself. But listen to this, but what he seeth the Father do. Oh, Jesus was so advanced in the realm of the Spirit that he actually saw the works of the Father before he acted them out. Wow. Thank God for such a level. Sometimes the Lord has shown me things, but most times it's an impression he gives you, and you just know what to do. An unction. You just act on it, and you see it happen. But the key is that we don't presumptuously go forth to do things. Sometimes I see preachers, they've had a meeting and God moved mightily, and they go to the next meeting and just declare boldly what God will do, and then disappoint everybody because nothing happens. Beloved, you don't assume that what he did in the last meeting is what he's going to do in this meeting. No, every meeting is different and uniquely tailored by God for that purpose. You cannot lead. You must learn to follow. Some of you are excellent controllers and manipulators, and you have not learned to follow God. You call on him all right, use the name of Jesus, you sing praise, but when it comes down to it, you are still running the show. Beloved, you have much more to learn, and I have much more to learn as we continue in this. May the Lord bless you and help you to follow him today and work miracles in his name, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. We love you. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.